Okay, so let's try this one. If I have Dekine and I use lithium and ammonia, what product am I going to be getting from this one, Brandon? Did you say? Yeah, the trans alkene, right? And it's going to be a dekene, so trans dekene. So the bi in this case, right? So one, two, three, four, five. That product there, right? Okay, so how do I get that product? So if y'all are wondering, remember there's still the... So that's the product that I get from these reagents. Let's learn the mechanism now, okay? So what we're going to do is erase this, erase that. So now you know what the product is. See, now you know where you're going. So if you're trying your mechanism, don't draw to go somewhere else, okay? Draw off where you're going. So lithium itself is a radical, right? It's got that lone electron. Whenever there's a radical, you're going to have a radical reaction, okay? In fact, what happens first is radical and then polar. It goes back and forth, okay? So what will happen first is you're going to do your fishhook arrows like that, and then fishhook like that. Okay, so you can think of, if you want to, your lithium like that, okay? So remember, whenever we have those metal atom organic bonds, metal carbon bonds, we really want to think of them more as carbanions, okay? So like the carbon itself has both of those electrons, okay? So what I'm going to do is kind of erase that and remind ourselves that we can think of them as carbanions with the lithium kind of just somewhere out over there. Remember we added ammonia as our solvent? Okay, so ammonia's got those protons on it. So if we have a strong base here, it's going to remove the proton from ammonia. So what happens? Now it's a polar arrow. Okay, so notice the double-headed arrow. Like that. So now we have you're going to have an excess of lithium. So it's 2 moles of lithium for every 1 mole of alkyne. So you're going to have another lithium atom. And guess what this one's going to do? Anybody? Do another radical reaction, okay? So, remember what I said, you're going to do a radical, then a polar, then a radical, then a polar, okay? That's how to remember this one. So, do your fishhook arrows, like that. attach there. Okay, but remember that metal carbon bond we think of as an anion. Okay? So, we'll erase that. Just to remind ourselves. In fact, let's get this lithium all away so we don't think it has anything to do with this. Okay, and now what's going to happen? That acts as a strong base, like we said before. Now you got the polar arrows, and we're going to make the transalkyne. And then if you want to, the other lithium amine. So this is the product. So how do you get a transalkene from an alkyne? Lithium and ammonia. Okay. How do you get a cisalkene from an alkyne? Do you remember?
Lindler's catalyst
and what?
H2.
Yeah, you have to put the H2 in there, or you won't get it. Okay, are there any questions on this mechanism? Questions?